slow poker.
I have a career and a family, but also play poker, which doesn't leave me much time. So let's get to it. I've got kings. But first, how did we get here?
Previously, on Slow Poker,
one dumb hand with this donkey granted me the superpower of poker invincibility. But this power can't last forever, so I could get ahead of it and just stop. Good advice, young man. Until I get enough, I will not stop. Also, I think your future looks bright and surely uncomplicated. I've got kings, and after he raises to 15, I make it 45, and he calls. I say a little prayer. No ace on the flop. No ace on the flop. No ace on the flop. Oh, that is such a dick move, Elphaba.
I know.
After he checks, the nerds at Red Chip Poker say that this is a slam dunk check back, but I can only dunk on second graders. So instead, I bet range for 35, and he calls. After this turn and another check from him, I don't mind a little pot control. He could have a made hand, like ace 3, and put me in a bind with a check raise. So I check, and after this river, he leads out for 100. This could be a bluff, or an ace, or two pair, or a straight, but you know what? Because I've got this, which means he can't have this, which means I've got two words.
All in.
And if you don't know, now you know that I bought that bird feeder for my dad for his birthday, and he loves his birds. So a word to the wise, don't fuck with my dad's birds. I've got Queen Jack offsuit, and while IMO, this hand is overvalued garbage, I decide to give it a whirl. But I've got my eye on you, Queen Jack, because as of now, you're
nothing!
And after this flop and a check, Queen Jack is still nothing. And while I could bluff with my gutshot draw, the way this game's been going, I'd bet that I'll have more than nothing soon. And I'll just start building the pot then. And this turn fulfills that prophecy. As now, I've got the
nuts, 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 nuts on the table!
Again?
He checks, I bet 25, he calls, and after this river, I no longer have the
nuts, 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 nuts!
'Cause the board paired!
Please don't leave me.
He checks, I bet 50, and he snap calls. With, of course, a king for three of a kind.
Wrong!
Oh, then I guess a 10?
That's one idea, or...
Well, this is kind of a long shot, but 9-8 offsuit?
Perfect.
Huh, well, that's something. As for Queen Jack, I take it back. In the end, you were more than nothing. Maybe you're not so overrated after all. I've got kings. He limps with a short stack. I raise to 25. He calls. And after this flop, my bet of 25, his jam of 66, and my call, he has one simple request. Oh, you wanted a 9 on you? A 9 on you, you say. Well, I guess we all know what hand you had.
I know it was you.
Queen Jack.
You broke my heart.
You know what? I take back my take back, Queen Jack. You're still overrated. I've got Queen 10 of hearts, and after he raises, I call, he calls, and this flop, and two checks. I could bluff, but in position against two players, I'll take a free turn card. And after said free turn card, he leads out for 15, and he raises to 65, and I'm dubious. I doubt that he has much, and I struggle to ascertain what strong hand he could have after checking flop. Granted, I only have Queen high, but I've got two draws, so I make a terrible call, as does he. And while this river does give me a pair, it's not the upgrade I was chasing. And as I prepare to make a trivial fold, they both check. After which, I hear the two sweetest words in poker.
Amen.
I hadn't even considered a third draw, and great job by me in missing that other draw. I mean, given how hot I'm running, frankly, it's kind of surprising that I somehow didn't drill the ginnest of gin cards, leading me to write another letter from the trenches.
Straight flushly yours. Slow poker.
But it is still divine intervention from the poker gods that the river wasn't one of these. I am one bad motherfucker. Not only do I keep winning pots, but I'm dodging bullets.
Did you really only win?
No, I did lose. There was this one hand. Raise, 3-bet, 4-bet, 5-bet, and I'm in the big blind with this. And fold. $5. Gone. We will rebuild.
I've got ace four. Raise to 15, get one caller, and at some point my luck will run out. But in the meantime, I'll just flop the nuts. Oh, of course, my apologies. Thank you for pointing that out. I never, for a moment, even considered that ace four is the second best possible hand, and I lose to the actual best possible hand, 6-4. A truly staggering revelation. Everyone out there, I beg of you, do not forget to regularly express your deepest gratitude to all the sharp-eyed commenters from across this great internet for doing the Poker Lord's work, always taking the time out of their busy days to make vital corrections just like this. Where would we be without the heroes? He checks, I bet 15, and he calls, and after this turn, he leads out for 40. Oh no. The keyboard heroes tried to warn me. He does have 6-4. That said, when I raise to 150 and he folds, there is a small chance he doesn't. And I take down a $252 pot with the stone cold with the lukewarm effective nuts. Is that acceptable? I've got 7-3, and you may wonder why I would play a hand so mediocre that even my camera lens is all hard pass. Oh, I think you know why. He limps, and she limps, and I check my option, which means it's time for the return of the OG Slow Poker miniseries. I didn't ask for this. Now everyone, prediction time. Given my ridiculous luck right now, what do you think the flop's gonna be? If you, much like my 10-year-old, guessed this, or this, that would be ridiculous. But this is too.
Pretty good.
She checks, I bet 5, and they both call. Okay, board, no matter what anyone else tells you, I think you're beautiful, and I mean it when I implore you.
Don't go changing.
After this turn, she checks, I bet 20, and they both call again. Now board, setting aside the times you have let me down.
You never let me down before.
After this river, she checks, I bet 95, he folds, and she snap calls. Oh, board, always remember that
I love you just the way you are.
I've got 7-6. Raise over a straddle to 30 and get two callers. And what you're about to witness is a heat check. For the uninformed, sometimes when a basketball player keeps making shot after shot after shot, they'll try a wild one just to test whether they're too on fire to miss.
Yeah, he wants a heat check. Three threes. Oh, that's a deep one. He shot it.
And that's what I do here, a poker heat check. On this flop, I bet 40, representing something huge, like an overpair. On this turn, I bet 125, representing something even huger, like middle set, I think. And on this river, I bet 210, representing... Wait, what am I representing? Whatever, does it really matter? When you can't miss, you can't miss. I've got aces, and this guy, who just sat down with a short stack, limps in for 5. I raise to 25, and he asks,
are you gonna gamble?
Well, you are.
Yeah, let's do it.
And then, unlike almost every hand in episode 17, pocket aces actually don't lose!
Anything's possible!
I've got kings, and at this new table, we're playing a special game within the game called the stand-up game. It means that after a round of this game starts, if you're the last player to win a hand, you pay a $25 penalty to every player at the table. And right now, with only a few winless players left, all fighting hard to avoid the penalty, it's a good time for kings. So I raise to 35 over a straddle, cutoff calls. Then the action is on someone I call William Tell, on account of his obvious tells, not visual tells, though I do notice those too.
Raise.
No, William has bet sizing tells. For instance, just a few hands ago, I had pocket jacks, and after I 3-bet someone to 45, William Tell made it 180. And given his patterns, that bet size is just pocket aces. That amount screamed, please go all in, please go all in, please go all in. But I don't go all in. I fold, he shows, I conquer.
Am I right? Did I call it?
I knew it.
So now, against my kings, William raises, but this time far bigger. Here, the size of Bill's raise tells a different story. This amount screams, I've got ace king, I've got ace king, I've got ace king. But Billy Boy, while I've been noticing your tells, you haven't noticed mine. And I've got two of them. One is that when I say these two words, I'm telegraphing that I've got King King, I've got King King, I've got King King. Then after I fade the snap call and hear the snap and you sigh call and I yay win, that's when you see my second tell, where with my hands, I do this chip stacking motion, which is a dead giveaway. I'm all but telling you, I've got your chips, I've got your chips, I've got your chips.
I tried to tell you, but you would not listen.
I've got ace four during a new round of the stand-up game, and the only ones left standing are me and the small blind. So I raise over a straddle to 35, and small blind has different plans.
No choice. I'm on.
Now, to all you poker novices out there, pay close attention. This lesson is on the house. Inferior players make a decision here too quickly, but a winning poker player is a deliberate poker player, one who carefully and rationally calculates every option on the table. I'll break them down for you. Option A, cut your losses with a fold. It's likely his hand is better than yours. In folding, you lose your raise of 35 and the stand-up game penalty of 120, equaling a loss of only $155. Option B, compound your losses with a call. This would mean that same 155 minus 435, given you'll probably lose the hand, equaling a 3x worse loss of $590. Option C.
I call.
What are you doing?
I'm teaching.
Okay, time to rack up and leave before this heater cools off. Unless, of course, I'm dealt a premium right now. Otherwise, it's over.
It ain't over.